Hello friends, in this video I will be talking about Commercial Mortgage Backed Securities, CMBS. Now, you've studied so much regarding RMBS. Exactly like RMBS, there is something known as CMBS. RMBS kya tha? Residential Mortgage Backed Securities. CMBS is Commercial Mortgage Backed Securities. It is nothing different from what you've studied. The only difference here is residential property nahi hoga, commercial property hoga. Have a look at this example in front of you. Ye hai borrowers, ye hai bank. Bank ne लोन दिया है लोन विथ कोलैटरल कमर्शियल प्रॉपर्टीज नाउ द कोलैटरल विच द बोरोअर हैज कैप्ट इज अ कमर्शियल प्रॉपर्टी कमर्शियल प्रॉपर्टी में देख लो टाइप ऑफिस बिल्डिंग्स वेयरहाउसेस शॉपिंग सेंटर्स और शॉप्स होटल्स हॉस्पिटल्स एंड मेनी मोर सो इट इज़ बेसिकली नॉट जस्ट रेसिडेंशियल इधर रेसिडेंशियल के अलावा इतने सारे प्रॉपर्टीज जो कवर्ड है दीज आर ऑल कमर्शियल प्रॉपर्टीज Now, bank will sell the loan to the SPE, my specific purpose entity. SPE will issue CMBS to the investors. Matlab, SPE is issuing asset-backed securities and the asset here is commercial mortgage. So basically, commercial mortgage ka jo pool hai, the loan pool is in backing of my ABS, which is known as CMBS, commercial mortgage-backed securities. Now, as shown in the figure, CMBS are securities backed by pool of commercial mortgages. RMBS kya tha? RMBS were backed by pool of residential mortgages. Similarly, CMBS is backed by pool of commercial mortgages. In order to assess the credit risk of the borrower, one can look out for two ratios. Now, you want to study the credit risk of the borrower. See, understand. ये है बोरोअर ये है SPE और फिर इन्वेस्टर्स दिस SPE शुड बी कंसर्न बिकॉज अगर बोरोअर ने पैसा नहीं दिया तो इट विल बी इन ट्रबल सो नाउ यू नीड टू असेस क्रेडिट रिस्क ऑफ द बोरोअर इन दिस केस नाउ देर आर टू रेशियोज विच यू नीड टू स्टडी बिफोर दैट मोर देन द बोरोअर वन नीड्स टू एनालाइज रिस्क ऑफ कमर्शियल प्रॉपर्टीज मॉर्गेज्ड See, ये जो borrower को आप study करोगे ना this was okay if it were RMBS. RMBS में क्या होता है the borrower has to earn some income and then it will try to repay. वो residential property है so it is not going to earn out of that property. But commercial property में क्या होगा Now, इधर risk of commercial properties mortgage जो है ना वो आपको ज्यादा study करना पड़ेगा So, you have to study the risk of commercial properties for CMBS. So you need to study borrower's credit risk for RMBS and you need to study commercial properties risk for CMBS. These two ratios to study are loan to value ratio, LTV ratio and debt service coverage ratio. These are for CMBS. So first one is loan amount divided by collateral value. Of course, you know this loan to value ratio. For investors, better is lower LTV. How is it better? Yaad karo, agar loan amount 1 million ka hai aur collateral 2 million ka hai. So it is good for the bank, it is good for the SPE, it is good for the investors, good for everyone except the borrower. Borrower kya sochega? 2 million ka property 1 million के लोन के सामने ये कोलैटरल हो गया है सो इफ एल टी वी इज लो देन बैंक इज हैप्पी एस पी ई इज हैप्पी इन्वेस्टर्स आर ऑल्सो हैप्पी नेक्स्ट डेट सर्विस कवरेज रेशियो दिस इज समथिंग न्यू फॉर यू सो द फॉर्मूला इज नेट ऑपरेटिंग इनकम फ्रॉम प्रॉपर्टी डिवाइड बाई डेट सर्विस वॉट इज नेट ऑपरेटिंग इनकम फ्रॉम प्रॉपर्टी उसका फॉर्मूला है नीचे देखना रेंट इनकम माइनस ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसिस माइनस डेप्रिसिएशन ऑफ दैट प्रॉपर्टी ये प्रॉपर्टी से जो भी इनकम आने वाला है इन शॉर्ट वो इनकम रेंट इनकम हो गया minus operating expenses. What are operating expenses? So if you want to maintain that property, there will be cleaning expenses, electricity expenses, and so on. Minus depreciation of the property. Now it is a non-cash charge, but still you will have to deduct that. Divide by interest plus principal repayment. See, debt service, in other words, I can say you have to service the debt or you have to repay the debt time to time. So debt service matlab amount of interest plus principal. Now a ratio greater than 1 means that income is sufficient to cover debt payments. See, if you are an investor, if you are SPE or if you are a bank, agar ye borrower ke paas commercial property hai aur uska debt service coverage ratio more than 1 hai. If it is more than 1, then check this original ratio. Isme numerator hai net operating income. If it is more than 1, my numerator has to be more than the denominator, which is really a good sign. So in this case, if the ratio is more than 1, then I am safe. My money is safe. Let's study one example. A shopping mall earning 200 million per year has been mortgaged. So basically this is CMBS because a mall has been mortgaged. The expenses amount to 90 million and it includes property taxes of 15 million. See, operating expenses 90 million diya hai aur property tax 15 million diya hai. Can I say property tax is also operating expense for a commercial property? Yes. Depreciation is 50 million and income tax is 15 million. The owner pays yearly interest of 6%. For this year, interest payment is 45 million and principal repayment is scheduled as 6 million. The question is there any credit risk? You are trying to study this borrower and his property for CMBS. You have to judge whether there's any credit risk. Now, you studied two ratios, LTV and debt service coverage ratio. Can you find LTV here? Loan divided by value? I don't think so, because there is no information given in the question. Let's go for DSCR, debt service coverage ratio. Formula kya tha? Net operating income from property divided by debt service, which was nothing but interest plus principal repayment. NOI ko break up karna hai to kaise hoga? Rent income minus operating expense minus depre divided by interest plus principal. Rent kitna hai? 200 million minus operating expenses 90 million. Now ek chota adjustment yahan par aayega. It includes property tax bola hai. Language pe dhyan dena. It includes property taxes of 15 million. Are property taxes operating expenses for a commercial property? The answer is yes. Should it be allowed to be deducted from this formula? Yes. And they have included 15 million in the amount of 90 million. Basically, you don't have to do anything here. Wo 90 million mein already include ho chuka hai. So 200 minus 90, that is right. Minus depreciation, 50 million. Now, the question arises, what about this? Income tax of 15 million. Iska kya karne ka? Income tax of 15 million, first of all, it is not an operating expense. If you have studied cash flow statements from FRA, you will come to know ye jo taxes hai, this is not operating. It depends on case to case. Just like ye rental income ke liye, property tax is operating expense. But income tax jo hai, it is not operating expense here. So income tax has to be totally ignored. Isko ignore kar do. So basically my numerator is 200 minus 90 minus 50 divided by interest, it is given 45 plus principal 6. Now whatever is the answer, if it is more than 1, then I am really safe. Basically there is no credit risk if the ratio is more than 1. Of course it is very obvious, this ratio 90 and 50, if you subtract from 200, your denominator is lesser compared to the numerator. So definitely there is no credit risk. Let's check the example. Now the answer says 200 minus 90 minus 50 upon 45 plus 6, 1.1764. Of course, there is no risk because the ratio is more than 1. Hint, ek hi hint tha yahan par. Property tax is an operating expense, but income tax is not. For CMBS, collection from tenants must be adequate and timely. But for RMBS, homeowner does not earn rent. So the owner's credit risk would be assessed first. See, these are the differences between CMBS and RMBS. If you remember this structure again, borrower, I'll cut off bank now, borrower, SPE and investors. अब ये SPE ने अगर RMBS issue किया है, meaning this borrower is an owner of residential property, क्या ये residential property से पैसा आ रहा है, कोई income आ रहा है? No, अगर rent आता तो वो commercial हो जाता. So now residential property से कोई पैसा नहीं आ रहा है, then how do you believe that this borrower is really going to repay the amount? By assessing the credit risk. This is what is written in the second point. तो borrower का credit risk study करना है. Similarly, if it were CMBS, then this borrower is earning some commercial property. So there we will study ye property se kitna income vagera aa raha hai. So we will study that the collection from tenants, is it adequate and timely? If yes, then you are at no risk. CMBS structure. Now these securities have unique characteristics. In order to mitigate prepayment risk and default risk, the CMBS structure has, there are two parts. It has pehla call protection and second balloon maturity provision. Let's study these in detail. First one is a call protection, and call protection has structure level or loan level. Loan level ke under there is something known as prepayment lockout, prepayment penalty points, yield maintenance, defeasance. We'll study each and everything in detail. Let's start with call protection. Call protection, a call means right to prepay. If you remember, callable bonds kya hota hai? Ye hai issuer, ye hai investor. इशूअर ने बॉन्ड्स इशू किया है. अगर ये बॉन्ड्स कॉलेबल बॉन्ड्स है तो ये जो बॉन्ड्स है ये इशूअर कभी भी बाय बैक कर सकता है और वी कैन से कॉल बैक कर सकता है. नाउ टू प्रोटेक्ट दैट, बिकॉज सी दीज इन्वेस्टर्स, ये जो लास्ट कैटेगरी है इन्वेस्टर्स, दीज इन्वेस्टर्स डोंट वॉन्ट टू गेट प्रीपेड. Basically, they have locked this amount and the interest income on it for 5 to 10 years. They don't want to get prepaid. That is why, ye jo callable bonds hai na, these are kind of risky. And here, we are talking about call protection. So basically, to protect that callable option, there should not be any callable option. Agar hoga, to compensate us. That is what we are trying to say. So, call means a right to prepay. In order to avoid prepayment from borrowers or to protect the investors when borrowers prepay, a call protection can be used at structure level and at loan level. Let's study structure level. CMBS can be structured in tranches. The tranches will be repaid sequentially. Tranche A receives principal repayments as per the schedule, then tranche B, C, D and so on. First tranche is again the safest. Last tranche is of course the riskiest. Now if the borrowers prepay, then the money will be paid to the last tranche. Just like pack and support, if you remember, pack ko sirf schedule ka paisa dena hai, prepay ka nahi dena hai. Similarly here, when borrowers prepay, the money will be paid to the last tranche. If borrowers default on some amount, then again last tranche might not receive any amount. Let's check an example. Now these are the borrowers. This is SPE and ye ho gaya investor. Now borrower kya karta hai? Borrower ko 10 million pay karna hai every month. $20,000 to the SPE, and SPE has to pay A and B. These are two tranches. Now, when borrowers have to pay 10 million, so ye A ko 5 or B ko 5 jata hai. This will get 5, this will get 5. By chance, in the next month, wo 10 ke badle 12 million deta hai. Borrower. Borrower is prepaying here. Then, A jo hai na, A wants structural level call protection. See, you are in call protection and you are at structure level. Now at structure level, A wants a call protection. Basically, A will get 5 only. Usko jitna scheduled tha utna. B will get 7 year. This is just like your pack and support tranche. So now, B ko prepayment ka risk zyada ho gaya. To B mein jo bhi investors hai, unko total 7 million mil gaya. Now, last month mein abhi sirf 8 million bachega na. To 8 mein se, again, A will get 5 only. And now B will get only 3. So in this case, again, A is safe from call protection and B is not safe. So this was structure level call protection. So aisa bhi ho sakta hai. Next is various names for the last tranche. Now just like you saw A and B here, we can even say A, B, C, D. So jo last wala tranche hai na, that is risky. So it has so many names you will find in the MCQs. First one is lower priority tranche or lowest priority tranche. Next is unrated tranche. Unrated kyun hai ye? Credit rating agencies don't want to rate this because it is so risky that they might be even wrong. Agar usne B ka rating de diya, to ye shayad D ka rating niklega. So these are not really rated by any agencies. We can also say residual tranche. What do you mean by residual? Bacha kucha. Jo bhi bacha kucha paisa rahega, hum isko de denge. So residual tranche. Equity like tranche. We can also call it equity like tranche because of the risk and volatility involved. And last, first loss piece tranche. What do you mean by first loss piece? Basically, out of A, B, C and D, D ko pehle loss hoga. D will absorb the losses first, and that is why it is known as first loss piece tranche. Now, earlier we studied structure level call protection. Now we study loan level call protection. There are four types of protections. Now, again, we are talking about this borrower, SPE and investor. Now here, we are talking about this category. Ye hota hai loan level. Earlier what you studied was this structure level. See, wo tranches wagera ko jo bhi support chahiye call protection se, that was structure level, basically between SPE and investors. Now we are talking about loan level, which is between borrower and SPE. Matlab, how do you encourage the borrowers not to prepay? That is what you are trying to study. So there are four types of protections. Pehla hai, prepayment lockout. Prepayment lockout, it is just like a lock-in period. Ke bhai, itne time mein tumko prepay nahi karna hai. So no prepayments are allowed for a period. Basically, we can keep a prepayment lockout. Prepayment lockout of say 4 years. Borrowers cannot prepay in these 4 years. So ultimately it is like call protection only, but for a limited period of time. Second, yield maintenance charges. Yield maintenance charges is basically penalty levied on the borrowers who repay loan before time. Matlab ke prepay by borrowing other loan, matlab ke refinancing at lower interest rate. If you remember, ye gisa pita example hai. Assume that you are a borrower. You borrowed a loan at 10% interest per annum for 10 years. Ab 2-3 saal ho chuka hai. Now you want to take another loan which is available at only 7%. So what will you do? 7% pe borrow karke 10% wala loan ko aap prepay kar doge. And to avoid from doing that, ye jo SPE hai wo kya aapko bolta hai ke you cannot do that. If you do that, then we will levy a penalty. सो बेसिकली रीफाइनेंसिंग किया तो आपको ये पेनल्टी भरना पड़ेगा. थर्ड, प्रीपेमेंट पेनल्टी पॉइंट्स, जस्ट लाइक व्हाट यू स्टडीड नाउ, पेनल्टी बट इट इज एक्सप्रेस इन टर्म्स ऑफ पॉइंट्स टू बी पेड बाय द बोरोअर्स हु वांट टू रीफाइनेंस एंड प्रीपे द लोन. 1 point इज 1% ईयर ऑफ द आउटस्टैंडिंग प्रिंसिपल लोन अमाउंट. बेसिकली जो बी वाला पॉइंट था और जो सेकेंड वाला पॉइंट था यील्ड मेंटेनेंस चार्जेस, इट विल बी एन अमाउंट लाइक से द पेनल्टी इज $10,000 और $20,000 एंड सो ऑन. थर्ड पॉइंट जो है प्री पेमेंट पेनल्टी पॉइंट्स, इट विल बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ पॉइंट्स और परसेंटेजेस वेर 1 point इज 1% ऑफ वट एवर द प्रिंसिपल इज आउटस्टैंडिंग. लास्ट वन, फोर्थ इज नोन एज डिफीजेंस. बोरोअर मस्ट प्रोवाइड फंड्स टू द एसपीई so that SPE can invest it in a portfolio of government securities. Out of the interest received on government securities, SPE will make payments to its investors. Try to understand ये क्या हो रहा है. Borrowers जो है उनका पैसा जो भी आ रहा है वो government securities में invest करेंगे for the time being, and out of that interest earned, SPE will pay their investors. So basically, if I check a diagram, this is a borrower, this is SPE और ये investor है. Now borrowers, if they are paying 10 million and एक महीने में अगर 14 million दे दिया, now this is more than the schedule, so basically 4 million जो extra है ना, ये SPE क्या करेगा, 4 million को government securities में डाल देगा, G-Sec. Now this will earn some interest, तो ये जब भी interest आएगा तभी SPE क्या करेगा, investors को उसमें से थोड़ा थोड़ा part देते जाएगा as per the schedule. This is known as defeasance. See the last line says basically payments received from borrowers are reinvested instead of prepaying the investors. Don't prepay your investors, rather invest it in government or safe securities and earn interest and then pay your investors on time. Now next one is balloon maturity provision. Now earlier you had studied call protection, which was at structure level and at loan level. Now the next one is balloon maturity provision. Balloon payment means substantial amount of principal is repaid on maturity. This you must be remembering, you studied this earlier. Aisa kuch to bhi tha, ye principal aur ye interest, principal kuch bhi repay nahi kiya, एंड में सीधा 1 million रीपे किया, बट इंटरेस्ट जो था उसमें थोड़ा अमाउंट पे किया, थोड़ा अमाउंट पे किया, थोड़ा अमाउंट पे किया, थोड़ा अमाउंट पे किया और थोड़ा अमाउंट पे किया. सो बेसिकली ये जो होता ना बलून मैच्योरिटी या बलून पेमेंट, एट द एंड ऑफ द टेन्योर यू विल पे द होल प्रिंसिपल. सो बलून पेमेंट मीन्स सब्सटैंशियल अमाउंट ऑफ प्रिंसिपल इज रीपेड ऑन मैच्योरिटी. बलून रिस्क मीन्स दैट बोरोवर विल नॉट बी एबल टू पे बलून अमाउंट ऑन मैच्योरिटी. बलून रिस्क का मतलब क्या है, ये डायग्राम में जो 1 million स्क्वायर किया है ना, ये रिस्क है, ये 1 million मिलेगा कि नहीं, दैट इज नोन एज बलून रिस्क. ही मे डिफॉल्ट इफ ही कैनॉट अरेंज फॉर रीफाइनेंसिंग और ही कैनॉट सेल द प्रॉपर्टी टू जनरेट फंड्स टू रीपे द लोन. वाई विल बोरोवर डिफॉल्ट, अगर बलून मैच्योरिटी है मतलब एट द एंड ऑफ 5 years फॉर एग्जाम्पल 1 million पूरा भरना है, तो देर आर टू केसेस, आइदर ही इज नॉट गेटिंग अनदर लोन टू रीपे योर लोन और उसका प्रॉपर्टी बिक नहीं रहा है, ही इज नॉट एबल टू सेल द प्रॉपर्टी. सो बलून रिस्क इन अदर वर्ड्स इज एक्सटेंशन रिस्क एज द टेन्योर इंक्रीजेस, बिकॉज 5 years में अगर वो रीपे नहीं कर पाया तो ही विल आस्क फॉर मोर टाइम, ही इज एक्सटेंडिंग दैट टेन्योर. सो बलून रिस्क इज एक्सटेंशन रिस्क. अ बोरोअर माइट गेट एन ऑप्शन from lender to extend this tenure. Basically extended period is known as workout period. Now if my tenure was 5 years and I'm not able to repay, so I will ask for some more, for example 2 years. Ye jo 2 years hai, what is this 2 years known as workout period or extended period. Now in this 2 years you work out, you earn money or you do whatever, 2 years le lo, pay my money back, and also to pay a higher interest called default interest rate. If ye jo original 5 years tha, here you were paying 8%, Now, for these 2 years or for this workout period, how much will you pay? 9%. Higher interest rate 9% को क्या बोलते हैं? Default interest rate. So, a lot of terms to remember here. पहला तुमने क्या सीखा? Balloon risk, which is the risk of not repaying the balloon payment. मतलब last वाला जो principal का payment था, शायद वो time पे repay नहीं किया. That is balloon risk, nothing but extension risk. अगर वो period extend किया, तो extended period को क्या बोलते हैं? Workout period. And workout period में जो interest rate लगता है, that is a higher interest rate, so it is known as default interest rate. Thank you guys for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda.